na dyan. Pakinig niyo ako.
Opo.
Pasabi niyo naman. Hindi ko na ilalagay itong headset. Kanina ako totally wala. Sige, sige. Okay, so I hope pakinig po ako. Pakinig po ba?
Pinig na po.
Pinig po.
So, this is po yung belt design, okay? So, ano po yung tinatawag natin na belt? These are mechanical component that are used to transmit power between two parallel shafts, okay? So, the shafts must be separated in a certain minimum distance, which is dependent upon the type of belt to be used, okay, in order to work most efficiently. So, ang ginagawa po natin dyan is that we have po yung dalawa na shaft po natin, okay? So, this shaft, these are loaded with a pulley, okay? And that pulley that has yung sheave, at dun po natin pinapadaan, okay, yun pong atin na belt, okay? So, you have here po yung belt, okay, to connect po the two. So, ganun lang po yung rotation po nung atin na belt, okay? So, ang kailangan po natin i-design dito sa belt would be yung kanyang length, okay? So, ano ba yung length, entire length ng belt po natin na gagamitin? Same thing with yung center distance, okay? So, the center distance is measured from yung center po nung isang shaft up to the center of the other, okay? So, yan po yung tinatawag natin as the value of C or the center distance. So, dapat po tama yung length na gagamitin natin, same thing with the value of C, para po magkaroon ng, mag-break po siya ng efficient, okay? So, yan po yung i-design natin in terms of the belt, okay? So, we have here the construction nung B-belt po natin. So, ito po yung kanyang cross-section. So, anong materials ang bumubuo po doon sa atin na V-belt, okay? So, here po is its cross-section. Tinawag po siyang V-belt kasi yung cross-section niya is almost like a letter V, okay? So, for the material, yung nakabalot po sa kanya, it is a rubberized woven jacket, okay? So, rubber po iyon wherein need po siya na rubber kasi siya yung in contact with yun pong ating pulley or yung sheave. So, there is a friction between them. So, kung hindi po yan rubber, ang posibleng mangyari is that yung mas madali po siyang mawit, masira, at saka po maputol. Okay? So, rubber din po siya para to provide yung elasticity po. Okay? So, pag-ikot na po doon sa atin ang mapuli, okay? So, mas madali po niya na magagawa. Wait lang ha. Hello? Hello? Ako'y nakaklase. Ngayon ako nakakonek. Ngayon nga ako nakakonek. Eh baka mamaya pa ako. Okay, so we have here po, okay, sa gitna naman po, this is made up of, ito naman po is made up of fabric or cord, okay, para pong yung katulad ng nakikita natin. If you see po yung mga rubber cans po natin, okay, pag ginupit mo po yan, sa loob makakakita ka ng mga strings, okay. So these are the fabrics or the cords that provide elasticity po doon sa atin na V-belt, okay. Ito naman pong gitna niya, okay, ito pong dalawang part na ito, these are resilient cushions. Okay, so this provide resiliency and also yung elasticity po needed by the belt. And then this one po, that would be the tensile layer. Okay, wherein ito naman po ginibigay niya is the strength, okay, na para mag ano naman po dun sa force na naka ano dun sa atin na V-belt, okay? So this is simply its cross section. So kumbaga yung cross section po ng belt, yan yung material na mga ginagamit po natin. Okay? So this should be perfectly fitted, okay? So meron po siyang thickness, meron po siyang width, okay? Tapos ito po yung kanya na length. So we will be deciding on the length, okay? So dapat po yung length na gagamitin natin, okay? Ay dapat na kailangan po makuha niya itong buong entire distance po na to, center distance, okay? So we okay, so this one is the schematic. Yes, Lisa?
Okay lang po.
Raising your hand?
Naririnig kanina.
Okay. So this is the schematic diagram of the belt pulley assembly. Okay? So ito po yung atin na dalawa na pulley, okay, na nakakabit po doon sa dalawa na siya. Okay? So yung mas maliit po, that is our driver. At yung mas malaki po na pulley, that would be yung driven, okay? So this is connected to the shaft of the driven machine, okay? Ito naman po, ganon din, okay? So usually, this is on yung po motor, okay, electric motor as the driver. Pero meron pa rin naman pong iba-ibang klase ng driver. So later po, we'll have there the listing, okay? So for the driver, we will use here subscript 1. And for the driven naman po, gagamitin po natin is subscript 2, okay? So we have here nomenclatures na ginagamit po natin for this setup. At yun din po yung gagamitin natin sa mga equations natin on designing the belt, okay? So here po is yung ating belt, ito po yung belt, yung nakapalibot po na to doon sa dalawang shaft po natin, okay? So we start first with D1 and D2, okay? So this refers to the diameter of the sheave, okay? This D1 would mean diameter of the driver, and yung D2 would be the diameter of the driven, okay? Tapos you have your N1 and N2. Ang N1 naman po and N2, this refers to the speed. So N1 would be speed of the driver and N2 would be the speed of the driven. Okay? So if you are to compare D1 and D2, of course D2 is bigger. Okay? And if you are to compare N1 and N2, okay, N1 would be higher than that of N2. Okay? So we can have the relation, okay, the belt speed, okay, the belt speed designated by Vm, this is equal to simply pi dn, okay, pi dn. And then if this is D1, this should be N1. So this is just the same also as pi D2 N2. Okay, pi D1 N1 equal to pi D2 N2. So you can cross out yung pi po natin and we can have D1 N1 is equal to D2 N2. And if you try to see relationship between diameter and the speed, we'll say D2 over D1 will yield N1 over N2. So we see here that they are inversely related. Okay, if you have a big value for D, okay, then mas mabab a small value of N naman is observed, okay? So the, you have here the lower the value of D, okay, the higher will be the value of the speed, okay? So they are inversely related, okay? So that would be N1 and N2. Next would be theta 1 and theta 2, okay? So we have theta 1 and theta 2. Theta would refer to the arc of contact, okay? So here is yung theta 1, okay? The arc of contact would mean the part wherein, okay, your belt is in contact with the shift, okay? So in this part, in our driver, so the arc of contact will start from this point up to this one, okay? So the entire angle here, okay, that is your theta 1. Okay, that is the angle of contact for the smaller shift or the driver. Here naman po, okay, so the contact between the belt and the shift starts at that point and then ends here. So from that point to the other one, okay, that would be your theta 2, okay? That would be the angle of contact of the driven machine, okay? And then we have also F1 and F2. So this is F1 and F2. F1 and F2, these are forces, okay? In particular, these are tensile forces, okay? So F1 would be the force at the tight side. And F2 would be the force at the slack side, okay? So yung tight side po, ito po yun, okay? And then the slack side would be the one having a loose belt po on the side. Okay? So, mas loose po dito kumpara doon sa nasa itaas. Okay? So, just like po yung atin na mga sa bicycle po, you have our chain. Okay? Yung roller chain po natin na ginagamit doon. Okay? So, yung chain po natin, as you observe, it is loose on one side and tight on the other side. Okay? That is to accommodate, okay, its rotation on the shift, okay? If these are both tight, okay, so failure would most likely to occur, okay? So mag-o-occur po yun kasi masyadong mahihila po dito. So there would be tension on this part, okay? And if that is both tight, then it is possible for breakage. If it's too loose naman po, both slack, okay? If it's too loose, then slippage will most likely to occur, okay? So kakalas lang po dito. So more prone to slippage. So there should be one side should be tight and then the other one should be loose, okay? To have a smooth running operation, okay? So those are F1 and F2. And then finally, you have their C as the center distance. So which is the center distance? Okay, that would be the distance from, okay, the center of the driver to the center of your cabin. Okay, so that would be the value of C. Okay, so this C value, okay, that must be designed in such a way that this will run smoothly. Okay, so again, that is what we will be designing in our V-belt. Okay, so let us have those parameters, okay, and the equations involved. to obtain those parameters that we have discussed. Okay, so this is the center distance, okay? So, ano po yung center distance? Again, it would be the distance from the center of the driver to the center of the driven machine, okay? So, we have what we call minimum center distance. So, why is that we have a minimum center distance, okay? So, when the distance between the pulleys is unknown, so if center distance is not given, then we assume to use the minimum center distance, right? So initially, we will be solving for the minimum center distance. So C minimum would be equal to D2 plus D1 all over 2 plus D1. D here pertains to the diameter of the driven and the driver, okay? So that is your equation 1. Another equation for C minimum, that equals D2 or the larger pulley, diameter of the larger pulley. You have to compare the two, okay? So the two values, okay, whichever is larger, then that would be used as your minimum center distance, okay? Again, you have to solve both, and whichever is larger, then that would be declared as C minimum, okay? So what will you do? What is the use of finding this minimum center distance? So this value is used in assuming the standard length. So you will be using this to solve for the standard length of the belt. Again, gagamitin mo po yan to solve for this. Okay? So once you know the standard length of the belt, then this will be used to find the actual center distance. Okay? So ito po yung focus natin. We want to know the real or the actual center distance. Okay, so you will be using only the minimum center distance for you to come up with the actual one. Okay, so this minimum is to be used for the standard length, which will give us the actual center distance. Okay, so that will be the process. Okay, now this is the formula for the actual center distance. Okay, actual is equal to b plus square root of b squared minus 32 quantity D2 minus D1 quantity squared all over 16, okay? Wherein yung B is in terms of L. 4L minus 6.28 D2 minus D1. L pertains to the standard length, okay? So this is the standard length. And, okay, so sabi ko kanina, C minimum, you compute for the standard length, you look for the standard length, and then from the standard length, you will be computing for the actual center distance, okay? So the actual center distance is in terms of the standard length L, okay? So this standard length L is obtained from table 17.3, okay? So I'll show to you table 17.3. Ulit lang po ha. I-open nyo po yung table 17.3 doon sa pinasok ko sa inyo. Okay? Palit lang ako dito. Para kita nyo rin po dyan. Okay, so this is yung pong table 17.3. To have a clear view po, paki-open nyo na lang po yung sinend ko po sa inyo na file kanina. Okay. So what is in table 17.3? Dito po natin makikita yung standard length. Alin po yung standard length po? Yun po nakalagay ay pitch length. Okay? So, paano po natin yan malalaman? Una, you have to know po the belt section. So, we have your A, B, C, and D section po. Okay? So, from the section po, okay, kailangan po alam din natin yung belt number. Okay? So, ito po yung belt number and the actual length, ito po katabi. Okay? Halimbawa po, yung if you have belt number A60, then that would be 61.3 inches in actual length. Okay? Yung A section po will have a diameter. Ano pong diameter na sinasabi dito is the minimum diameter of the driver. Okay? So, minimum diameter po for A section is 3 inches. For B section, that's 5.4. For C is 9. For D section is 13. Okay? So, yan po yung atin na mga sections. Okay? So, anong gagawin po natin dito? Paano po natin malalaman ang standard length? Okay? So, you will be computing for the length. Okay? So, isosolve po natin yung length. So, base po dun sa computed value, titingnan mo po siya doon sa particular section, alin yung pinakamalapit sa kanya. Halimbawa po, yung na-compute po natin na length is 100 inches. Okay? So, halimbawa, nakita po natin nasa B section po siya. Halimbawa, na-identify mo po yung section, nasa B section po siya. Hahanapin mo po ngayon dito sa pitch length yung pinakamalapit sa 100. So, tingnan mo, go over ka po dito, yung pong 100 is in between 98.8 and 106.8. Ang pipiliin po natin ay kung alin yung pinakamalapit sa kanya, regardless as kung mas maliit ba siya o mas mataas. Okay? So, basta po mas malapit. So, ari lang po yung pagpipilian natin on the B section. It would be 98.8 and 106.8. So, if it is 100, mas malapit po siya doon sa 98.8. Okay? So, this 98.8 will have a belt number of B97. Okay? So, if you are looking for the standard length, then that would be 98.8. Okay? As the standard length. Okay? Again, you have to solve for the computed length. Okay? And this computed length on the particular section, okay, just take a look at the values to where it is nearest, okay? So, the nearest value to the computed length would be chosen, okay? Say, for 100, then we use B97 having a standard length of 98.8, okay? So, balik po ako dun sa kanina. Okay, so we have here the length of the belt. This is how you compute for the belt, okay? You have here two configurations. This is for the open belt, okay? This is the open belt wherein the belt rotates here freely, okay? So to compute for the length of this belt, you have here 2C minimum plus pi over 2. This is pi over 2, then quantity D2 plus D1, okay? Plus D2 minus D1 quantity squared over 4C minimum. Okay? This is for the open belt. But then if you have here a cross belt, okay? So the other one, the other configuration, we have here the cross belt, okay? Wherein they cross at point C. Okay? So papaganan po yung rotation natin. Ganyan, okay? So they cross at point C. So to determine the length, this would be the equation. 2C minimum plus pi over 2. D2 plus D1 plus quantity D2 plus D1 quantity squared over 4C minimum. Okay? So, the 2 is the same doon po sa dalawang nauna na terms. Okay? If you are to compare that with equation, okay, for the open belt, the same po on these two equations. Okay? Yung doong two terms po na yun. Okay? The first two terms, they are just the same. It is only on the third term na nagkaiba po sila. Okay? This one makes use of minus. Okay? For the cross belt, you have there plus. Okay? So, you expect it would be bigger. Okay? The length for the cross belt that would be higher than that of the open belt. Okay, you use here plus, the other one makes use of subtraction. Okay, so a cross belt has the advantage of large contact angle. So in terms of the contact angle, of course, this would be bigger. This is the contact angle. This would be theta 2. Okay, in terms of theta 1, okay, so this would be your theta 1. So you expect a bigger contact angle for this cross belt, okay, as compared to the open belt, okay? And then, but then there is also an advantage. The wear due to the rubbing at the point of crossing is a disadvantage. So they cross at this point, okay? So that there is a tendency na mag-wear po doon. Okay? Kasi lagi sila nag-rub against one another. So the thickness would be affected. And if there could be yung breakage po, most possible doon po sa point where they meet, okay? The point of crossing. Okay, so that would be its advantage. We have classes at 2:30. I think parang hanggang 2:30 lang tayo. Hello? Hello po?
Wala po.
Wala naman. Can I continue?
Sige lang po.
Okay, hanggang ano lang naman? Say 2:45 lang. Okay? Okay. No, hindi nagka-abarya lang kanina. Okay, so that would give us the value of the length. So ito po yung sinasabi kanina, if you have there the computed length, that this would be the computed length, this 2, okay? So this computed length, okay, you go to the table which I show earlier, and you look for the standard, okay? So you are to look for the standard. Given this length, so you go to the particular section, and then look for the value to which this is nearest, then that would be the standard length. Okay, what about the area of the arc of contact? Okay, so the arc of contact may be solved using this equation. So this equation is for an open belt. Okay, so your theta is equal to pi plus minus d2 minus d1 over c actual. Okay, yung plus po would be given, okay, would be used, okay, theta would be equal to pi plus D2 minus D1 all over C actual, okay? If this is, okay, if this is for the larger pulley. So this is for driven, okay? Wala. So this is for driven, okay? But then for the driver, then that would be pi minus D2 minus D1 over C actual, okay? So this one would be for the driver. Okay, or the smaller pulley. Okay, so the two matters as to plus and minus. Okay, for a cross belt, you make use of this equation. Okay, for a cross belt, the larger pulley and the smaller pulley is assumed to have the same value of the arc of contact. Okay, so it is only on the open belt that they differ, but then on the cross belt, they would be the same. It is equal to pi plus 2. Sine to the negative 1, R1 plus R2 over C. And C would be your C actual. Okay, so this is the actual center distance, which I have given you earlier the equation for the C actual. Okay, so that is how you obtain the value of theta. Now, for the V belt, okay, so we have here the design consideration. So these are the method, okay, on how you will be designing for the belt. First, you compute for the design horsepower. So the design horsepower is equal to NSF times transmitted horsepower. This one, then this is called the service factor, okay? So the service factor is the condition on how you use the machine, okay? Whether you use it occasionally or intermittent or you use it ordinarily, o kaya naman po on severe environment, okay? So this is affected by those conditions, the service factor. And this service factor is taken from table 17.7. Whereas the transmitted horsepower, that is the nameplate rating, okay? Say for example, you have the electric motor, meron po doon naka-define na transmitted HP. So you call that the nameplate horsepower. Or If you have there the shaft, it is its transmitting power. So the transmitted power, yun po yung transmitted H pin po natin. Okay, so let us take a look first of the service factor. So you are on table 17.7. So get your copy of this table 17.7.
Wala ulit din ang
pang-alis.
So, this
is one of the...
Okay, so this is your table 17.7. Okay, so this is table 17.7. Paki-check nyo po yung copy ninyo. Okay, so this is the service factor. Wherein you would see there, okay, the driven machine. So you simply take a look at this column and see what is the driven machine. And here naman po is your driver. So what type is your driver? Say for example, you have there an electric motor, AC split phase type. Okay, so you make use of this column. And then say for example, the driven machine is a compressor. Okay, then the intersection of the two, this is compressor. And then electric motor for the driver, then your NSF or the service factor is equal to 1.2. Okay? So yun po yung pagkuha ng value ng NSF. So simply take a look at the driver, what type is it, okay? And then have its particular column. Okay? And then same thing with the driven machine. So let us choose kung alin po dito, hanapin po natin on the listing. And the intersection of the two, that marks your regular, okay, we call it the service factor for the regular operation, okay? But then, you have there a note, okay, on our, yes, Jared? Hello?
Napindot lang po, ma'am, sorry po.
Okay, so we have here a note on our manual. We have here a note on our manual. It says here that for service factor, add 0.2 for continuous operation and wet environment. So if you are using the machine for continuous operation, so the one that you see on the table, okay, you add that by 0.2. Okay, because this is not a regular operating condition. Okay. But then if it is used occasionally or seasonal or intermittent, then you subtract 0.2, okay? So you identify there 1.2 coming from the table. But then the belt is used occasionally or seasonal. So instead of 1.2, you have to subtract 0.2. So you'll use only 1, okay? But then if it is not stated that it will be a use occasional or it is not on continuous operation, then you make use of the regular condition po niya. Okay, so the factor is the one written in the table, okay, of the service factor. Okay, so no need to add 0.2 or subtract 0.2. So that would be the value. Okay, so that is how you compute for the design HP. So you multiply it by the service factor. Okay, the second one is to choose the belt section, okay? So you have to know where it is located. Is it on the A section, B section, C, D, E section, okay? So how do you determine the belt section? So to determine the belt section, necessary that you know the design HP, okay? So you make use of figure 17.14, okay? So you look at 17.14, this will tell you what particular section is to be used. Okay, so punta po tayo. You open yung figure
17.14.
Okay, so this is figure 17.14. So on the x-axis, you would see there the design HP. So for number one, what we have computed there for the design HP, okay, hahanapin po natin on the x-axis. Okay, And on the horse, on the y-axis, okay, you have here the speed, okay? This should be the speed of the driver. So this would be N1, okay? So you have to look here for N1, and then on the x-axis would be the design HP. Say, for example, design HP is 10, okay? 10 horsepower. You have computed for the design HP equal to 10. And then the speed of our driver is 1,000. So you have your 1,000, and then you have there 10, okay? So at what section it is? This would be on the B section, okay? So nandyan po yung ating border, okay? Yung borderline po between each section, okay? So if you have there 10, design HP, and 1,000, so that falls under the B section, okay? And on this section, V10 is the value of the width and the thickness, okay? So you simply have to copy, okay? All on the B section, okay? Nagmamatter lang po is the length. But then the value of B and T, that would be the same. Okay, so this figure, okay, tells you on what belt section would be used. Okay, so that would be our step two. Okay, so I think I'll continue this on our next meeting since masyado na din ako overtime. So thank you. Okay, so you try to continue po, okay, 3, 4, and 5, okay, para dun po sa mga may klase. Okay, so I'll just have the discussion for the remaining next meeting po natin. Okay, nakuha po ba? Hello?
Yes po, ma'am.
Okay. So pakibasa na lang din po initially, okay, para matandaan po natin kung ano yung mga figures po natin at tables na gagamitin. Okay?
Okay po, ma'am. Thank you po.
Okay.
Thank you po.